Everybody, welcome back to the Awesome Goalkeeper. Today we're back playing our Sheffield Wednesday career mode. It's going to be absolutely incredible. Okay, they're trying to sell me long shots. We are getting into our game against Swansea straight off the bat. I will look at the team though, and there's also a couple of minor changes I want to do. I was discussing it with my scout, Mr. C, today. And basically, we got Eddie Nketiah on the lineup, obviously, from our loan to buy with Arsenal. So as you can see here, Eddie Nketiah on the left side of things. What I'm thinking of doing is, obviously, with Kachunga leaving in January, oh wow, this guy is 100-100 and he's very happy. Well, very happy, 100 sharpness. But with him going, we need a new right winger to take the spot over here. So that is where Nketiah will come in. Nketiah will be in the spot over here on the wing. Izzy Brown will be over here on the wing. So that's how things are going to roll. Xerxes will be up front with Ferreira. And I will be sending a couple of people out on loan. So I bet you're thinking, well, what about Somerville? He will be going out on loan. Some people might not like that, but he only has a potential of 80. He won't be going this season, so we've still got him for a little bit. But for the upcoming seasons, when we get into the Premier League, he won't cut the league for us there. So that's why we're going to develop Nketiah. I don't know whether we can though, because he is only on loan, so I don't think... Actually, yeah, I just might as well just do it now. I don't think Arsenal would be too happy with me if I do this. Oh, I can! I should be able to then. So, he is on a loan to buy, so we will be buying him at the end of the season. So we just need to look for a right winger. Only 2 weeks, that's great! We'll put you in there for 2 weeks. Oh, I have also been informed by a wonderful person in the comments called XReaperZen. Check out his YouTube channel, I'll link it in the description. That maybe this isn't the best and we need to give them more rest days. So, before match is obviously going to be a rest day, after match recovery day. We will still give them rest. So if I put only training, then that's fine for these bits, but what I will do is here, oh no, I don't want to advance, I'll change route, no, I don't think I can change it for particular days. I think we will have to do the intermittent training then. That's what we're gonna have to do, so I apologize about that, but I still want to train, and that's the only way to train because we need that for the sharpness. So that's what I'm gonna have to do, so I will have to keep it like that. So we have got an okay morale, so that's not that bad though. It looks like Roma FC. Oh, that's Roma. Oh, I forgot they lost God, they lost all of that. The licensing to Roma. Yeah, might as well go for you. Nothing special here so far. Yep, nobody special in Albania. Yeah, none of them even needed. We'll go for this one. Wales seems to be giving me the best players. Some of these guys could be 62 overall, but I'm looking at the potential. 94 potential. Yeah, I'll go for you with that amount that you're worth as well. So I don't want to get people like this guy who's only 69 potential. I might go for this 81 potential as well and just loan him out for the rest of his life. Yeah, I'll do that. And then Oh, I need to reject people now. So, Berisha does have a 92 potential, but he could only reach 68. So that's not looking promising. Oh, he's able to be promoted now. Let's promote you. My scout has lots of thinks he's got lots of potential. Okay, let's have a look down here. There's a couple of 94 potentials, but that's the, oh yeah, I'll go for you. Right, that's it then. That is this. So I will set that up and we will now get into the game against Swansea. I think I should have turned this off because now India want me to be their manager. No, I don't want to manage you, India. No offense, I don't want to manage you. Whew, right, let's finally load into the game against Swansea, who I thought was 71st then. But no, they're only 7th. So they are challenging for playoff places. Let's just get straight into this. Finally. Start with, Windows has hit 70. So I think he's only 24 years old, so we will be able to keep him for a while. Xerxy up top with Cook. Somerville on the right, Brown on the left, he's gone up to 72 now. Lep stays in goal with Lees, Luongo, Iorfa in the back. Westwood has gone back up to 72. Don't ask me why he went to 71. Or I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, he went to 71. I may be mistaken.
The Liberty Stadium in Swansea. My name is
but
Derek Ray,
I think I remember last episode always, he went down to 71. But anyway, he's quickly rose it's in those Swansea stats. So that's all that matters, really,
yeah,
isn't it?
Derek, as always,
just so long as he's
here.
Good when you need him.
I have to say, the atmosphere is fantastic in here. And I'm anticipating a really good game today. Hopefully,
make the run.
Won't be disappointed.
He's made the run.
And
it's on it, Somerville. Across into Windus, who's just gone up and over all himself. Oh, what a save from the Swansea goalkeeper. Absolutely beautiful stop. How he's kept that out, I do not understand. That's a goal any other day. Somerville across goal. Windus, the desperate leap from the Swansea keeper. Off, just, it's off where his elbow is from the other side. Was it off his armpit? Just off his armpit. But that, my friend, is goalkeeping to be proud of. That's an absolutely incredible save. And then I thought that this, oh, he looks like he's a youth player, because, yeah, he's definitely a youth player. Pounds it over the crossbar. Very unlucky to not be 1-0 up. But I've got to give credit to that keeper.
Well, Derek,
that was a disgustingly good save. Absolutely incredible. Something to cherish the rest of your career, pulling one of those out. Yes, it's only against a 24-year-old Windus, but still, it's absolutely incredible, and you cannot take anything away from that. Why Cook didn't run onto that, I do not understand. So it was a side tackle just to bring him down. Oh, given away cheaply across to Win. Oh, and what a goal from Luongo! Absolutely emphatic finish. Full strike from the Australian. Going to go on his international duty, so we will be missing him for the next 2 weeks, if the championship doesn't stop, I cannot remember fully. But I was like, why hasn't he passed it across? But Luongo pulls one out of the bag. Beautiful goal.
Concentration is everything.
The keeper pulls out an incredible save. We pull out an incredible goal. 1-0. Let's go, Massimo Luongo. Bringing it forward, but taken down by the Swansea man. Routledge looking to break. Back to Lep, cool as a cucumber. Make the run.
This might have potential.
But he's on it. We're looking for the players to get into the box. Nobody was there when they were needed. Oh, but Xerxes pulls it from the defender. But it was not a very good shot. Scuffed it. I thought he'd whip it around where the keeper was, rather than going for the post closest. I think if he bent it round, he'd have had more of a chance, if it was on target, of scoring than there. And that cross was a little bit bluff too. Still stands 1-1. 1-1. 1-0 here at wherever Swansea Stadium is in Wales. Well, I know it's in Swansea, not that dumb, but whatever their stadium's called. And nothing big really happening at the moment. Apart from if Somerville passes this well to Brown. How we haven't scored there with Crook, I do not understand. Looking for the attack, Somerville cuts in. Windus, goal. Easy finish. Absolutely hit that home beautifully.
Well, Derek, take another look at this now. There's
another dodgy cross though. Simple finish from there. But the crosses are a little bit dodgy. I think I might have to up the sliders again. We've already got used to the new slider difficulty. Whew. If you guys would like me to up the difficulty, then let me know. I will up it for the next two games and let me know if you prefer that. Also, would you guys prefer the videos to be shorter? I prefer, personally, when I watch career mode, if they're any less than half an hour, I don't like them as much. But, all hit the post, but if they're shorter than that, they're a bit more naff and you can't get as much done. You can't see as much of the games. But if you guys prefer them shorter, I can do them in two halves, or so like, half of the upload, so you watch one game maybe on the first day, two on the second, or two on two. But that might mean that the videos aren't as good a quality, as I'm trying to ram enough things in for one video's worth into that time. So, as you guys know as well, it is the school holidays now for 2 weeks, so there'll be a lot more career mode content with Sheffield Wednesday, which is great, so we should be hopefully, definitely by the end of the season, by Sunday, not this week Sunday, if you're watching this like when you're meant to be, but the next Sunday. So I believe that that's like the 26th or something ridiculous, at least.
They are on the move again. A chance to whip it in.
Crosses are so broken. Well, actually, I'm going to quickly check if it's just me or... Oh, that was just me then. Okay, they're not broken.
Now they're going to alter things. Here's
they've just not got aimbot. I forgot to install aimbot, you know. You know how it is. You've got to buy Passbot, don't you? Otherwise, you can't pass very well. So, like FT Text uses Passbots. So, yeah, let me know in the comments because I want to know. So, it'll help me when I'm putting the clips together.
Give them a game any day of the week. That should be a belter. And the conditions look pretty good for the counter attack. He's in behind. Must be.
What a save from the keeper again. When I'm upping all the other difficulties, I might have to lower his. It's absolutely incredible.
It's a third goal for Norwich City. 60 minutes played, 3-1.
Cheers again, Alan.
Oh, and they're through. Oh, I'm just over the crossbar. Ever so close. I'm going to bring Hargis on. Overlooked, definitely. But it would have been over any keeper.
Tom Lees.
It's what was needed to be done.
Another live game in the championship coming your way on EA TV.
Given away cheaply. Had to come in with a tackle. Thankfully didn't take the man.
No nonsense clearance.
Attempted clearance, but it wasn't very good.
Oh, not great defending.
Oh, and a good outstretched block from the defender. Hargis with an absolutely beautiful ball to Brown, who was unfortunately offside, outside of the boot, chipped through. What you love to see from a youngster.
We'll have two additional minutes. Brown.
Brown again with the lofted through ball. Oh, the fancy footwork from Windus.
How can he take them on and beat them?
Oh, and the outstretched trailing leg of the defender.
So the final whistle here.
I didn't hear much from Nketiah. Watch him not be in the team and I look stupid. Yeah, he wasn't in the team, was he? Anyway, I'm really dumb. So it was a 2-0 win. They're comfortable 2-0 win. I will up the difficulty again. So that'll be no problem because we've won 4 games in a row now of being playing, and I don't want it to be like that because it's meant to be hard. I've straightened things out with you apparently. Well that's great, Rhodes. I'm glad you think that you're playing well here. Because we don't need you anymore, really. That's the best way to put it. Right. So let's have a look at what games we will be playing today. So we've got the 2-0 win against Swansea. We've got QPR, Millwall, Barnsley, Rotherham. And we've got Bournemouth, Reading, Cardiff, and Birmingham. So I'm going to play Birmingham, Bournemouth, and Millwall or Rotherham or Millwall, I think. Wait, so we played one, playing Bournemouth and Birmingham. Oh, so I'll just be playing Bournemouth and Birmingham then. Right, so I'll sim and I'll do all the sims off camera and I will see you when we are playing against Bournemouth. A 1-0 win against QPR, a draw against Barnsley, a loss to Millwall, but a 2-1 win against Rotherham. So just gonna sim to Bournemouth. That's who we're playing next. Hongmin wants to be their manager, no. Sorry.
Grunewald. Please come to reception. Your wife is Gosling.
Oh my gosh. I wasn't recording. Wow, so I would go into instant replay and show to you guys everything that's happened so far. This is not good at all, right. I've got to go to all the players until I can get back to the ball again, great. So you're probably seeing everything going on in the slow-mo places. Wait, I just exited. I'll get you to the right point. So I've got us to the first goal. It was a throw-in into Kachunga, who played a ball through the legs over Nketiah into where Izzy Brown was, who first time whipped that right into the top corner. There was nothing anyone can do about it. Beautiful finish with his left foot. Begovic looking like a giant in that goal. But Izzy Brown with the finish, and I'll just exit it again. Thank you very much. The second one all started with just a normal Bournemouth attack, or normal Bournemouth running. They was on the ball, Then number four, who I believe is it Cook? Gosling. Lost the ball to Ferreira, who saw the run of Izzy Brown really early as he was coming past him. Waited, lofted it. Sorry, it wasn't Izzy Brown, it was Nketiah. On the ball. There's nobody in the middle, can I say, just defenders. You see Cook running in, calling for the ball, but Nketiah goes alone. Whips it with his right foot around Begovic into the back of the net. A disgustingly good finish. And the fact that I wasn't recording King of the live reaction is also disgusting, but not in a good way. Cook has walked himself into starting lineup so far, and he's shown that he's worth it. Brown on the 73 overall, but couldn't keep that in play. But I saw in that starting lineup, Brown has gone up from 72 to 73, which is great. I hope he keeps on growing. I will definitely sign him at the start of next season, if possible. If possible. So that would be great. Oh, but he's drawn Dunkley out position. And don't ask me what Windus was doing in defence there. It was good that he was in defence, but what he actually did with that weird slide tackle. A bit dodgy. Bournemouth looking dangerous. Leaves with a good slide tackle.
The hosts really haven't had too much of the ball, but they won't muck.
And they could do damage.
Izzy Brown, all alone. Into Cook for his first goal, is it?
Well,
I think it's Cook's first goal.
A highly impressive performance.
I mean, you just got to. He's so happy with himself. Spinning out of control. Brown could have easily gone for that alone. One on one with the keeper. I saw Cook running in. I wanted to get the young Estonian a goal. Oh, he did score. He scored last episode. But it's a beautiful strike, a clean strike from the youngster. He's looking about 30, but he's only 16, 17, would you believe it? And he has got a full future ahead of him. A full future. 3-0 against Bournemouth in half time. I might have to up it again, you know. I've already got used to this one in the first 10 seconds of it. Beautiful goal. Beautiful goal. And we're already looking bright into Kachunga, who's off. I knew he was offside as soon as I played the pass. 3-0. Into King. Goes alone, probably not the best option. I would have always played that across if I were him.
So the half-time whistle
and the half-time whistle
and
blows. And comfortable at the start. I believe Voice should be on the bench, or he isn't. That's a shame. I'll give Coughlin some time. Oh, Somerville has gone up to 69. I'll put him in front of Kachunga. And the team will stay the same. So two subs at half time, Sheffield Wednesday 3, AFC Bournemouth 0. He's given away cheaply in defence, which is something that I've said a lot this episode.
And a good looking pass.
A terrible slide tackle, not comfortable. A classy pass. This is reminding me of Stoke. We get the ball, we pass it back to them.
Just looking ahead to another game coming up.
But
for
Cook
you
with the interception, passed straight back to them.
It's Sheffield Wednesday.
Again, not looking good for us. But Ferreira on it.
There.
Hopefully. A beautifully weighted ball over the top. He goes alone. Oh, but Ferreira couldn't put it in the back of the net. He just couldn't volley it in the right part of the ball with the right part of his foot where he could get a clean connection. If Begovic parried it, though, from his positioning, that would have been an atrocious own goal to concede. But Coughlin wins that header well. Oh, but given away.
Well, that is how to
Oh, one-on-one with the keeper, surely. Westwood Oh, and Coughlin. Oh, and he was worth bringing on the bench just for that.
King. Opportunity it is.
Shot straight into Westwood. Can he get a good dart this time? He can.
Well, you learn the script time and time again, and he's
again a bad pass out. Back into Bournemouth Street. Oh, but that is terrible from Lees. I think I just got in a red card, to be honest. Two nasty tackles in a row. Just a yellow. Gotten away with that. I'm not sure about Bournemouth's kit. They've got no sponsor like us. It's a bit plain. I'm not sure on Sheffield Wednesday's kits, to be honest. I think they're pretty plain, pretty boring. But it's all right. All is fine. Oh, and again, very nearly over the bar. I have upped the difficulty, but the style is the same. I will shot. Where's their shot error? I'll bring that down to 25 because some of these shots really should be going in and they're not. Even with the help of the sliders, they still can't finish one-on-ones. Beautiful ball over the top into Somerville to chase. And that was a cross. Begovic. Abnormally close to his line.
I understand there's been a change to the scoreline in the Brentford match. Alan
but he is such a giant, isn't he, Begovic? He is incredibly tall.
Many thanks, Alan.
Looking for Ferreira, who's one-on-one with Begovic. I don't know why my controller is shaking. Wait.
They
put a goal decision system on there. That is actually quite funny. Why would they do that? We got a red card? So he got shown two yellows. I thought we'd gotten away with that. Well, well, well. Oh, obviously I can't substitute him. Well, well, well. This is very different to what I was expecting to happen today. We have had a man ejected from the starting 11. So straight away the left is the easiest option. So he got shown two yellow cards because he hadn't picked up a yellow card before that. Definitely not on the highlights and definitely not before anyway. Or at least one that I don't recall. But looks like we got a man sent off without even knowing. Very surprising.
And Adam Smith on the ball.
Oh, Coughlin though, that was really good from the 17-year-old Welshman. As he darts in. Through. Oh, can he finish? No, he can't. Can he finish? Oh. And the young left back couldn't find the back of the net after two times of trying. A good block from the defender.
Short corner it is. And Kessia.
Well, giving away not what you want to see, but into Coughlin, who's still in the attack.
Moving forward effectively, and he might be
he's got
here.
To finish. Oh, and the young man, the young Welshman, has finished. First goal in senior football.
Well, here's the replay, and it's a decent move to evade the defender.
He will
and
go far.
All the, time in the, world, you
all
can
the way,
your lines,
darting in between the defenders.
And slips it past the keeper beautifully.
Begovic nowhere near. He was closer to hitting the post than hitting Begovic. As it's a 4-0 well, in the 89th minute, we play the injury time, probably me checking our man being sent off. A little bit questionable. But he was definitely shown a yellow card in the bits that I skipped.
Good work to regain possession.
Definitely wasn't shown a red. So I remember saying, oh, it's only a yellow card, that's lucky. After two yellow card offences, I thought it would have been. You know what, we'll go with the post-match interview. Last time they kept thinking that we was giving debuts to players who already scored, so that was a little bit bizarre, but we're going to speak to the press about this Bournemouth thrashing. He's come through the ranks. We do have plenty of young talent at the club, because we've got a load of people in our youth academy as well. Leeds is suspended, a big miss for the team. These things are part of the game though. We will get, why is Coughlin suddenly happy? That ended up being a very comfortable, yep, very easy. We were ruthless up front, we really were. Coughlin's so getting very happy about everything I say, even though it's not targeted at him. But yeah, why is Coughlin hit the headlines? What about them beautiful finishes early on in the game? He scored in the 89th minute. So yeah, let's get into our third and final game against Birmingham City. Birmingham are putting very high pressure on us, so we can't play the quick around the back passing like normal. We've seen the run into the middle, into Windows, finish. The difficulty has been upped and we are the early squad, we really are. Always, oh, I've skipped it. Always very early on in the games we score. Hopefully this is like Norwich where it's full of goals, or like Derby where we try and hold out. I don't like playing the games where I'm thrashing them. It's really boring. Hopefully that won't happen in today's game. Oh, it really won't if they're going to play like that. Birmingham have already finished. Lupp had no chance. First time shot by Torval into the bottom corner. It's not going to be like that today. We could very well lose this game. I really, really need to work on my defending. I'm going to do some training on that. I love how our defender's like, offside, offside. I thought he was offside, but he clearly wasn't, according to the linesman. Sorry, behind me. And it's a finish from Birmingham.
A level contest. 1-1.
And we have conceded, and it's 1-1 in the 16th minute. Let's hope that that doesn't cost us. I was trying to make some of it go for the run, but he wasn't having any of it. Gosh, I think I've been speaking too much today, you know, my voice is going. Leeds is on it though, and again Birmingham strong.
Tremendous vision. Cross could be useful, and the danger clear. Really getting stuck.
And that is an obvious free kick for us. See you, Xerxes. Oh, and unfortunately, we couldn't play him through.
Harley Dean.
Terrible tackle from Windus there. Terrible tackle. Hopefully they don't send him off randomly, like last game. Oh, but Luongo with the interception.
Windass.
Oh, and I really messed up that attack there. Really messed up that attack.
Toral. And room now out on the wing. In possession to give them the lead, maybe.
Oh, and I've took him out, and that is going to be a straight red and a penalty. Another red card. Oh, it's just yellow. I'd say that's a red card. What do you guys think? And a save from the young Estonian keeper, Lep. He went the right way, and he didn't let that Birmingham, the nasty Birmingham striker, finish. A beautiful save from Lep.
So the corner play.
Just get it clear.
Box.
Please don't head around that way again when I ask you to head the other way. We don't want another corner to be given.
Over it comes.
Well, oh, and another Lep is going to be incredible. You can just tell with this boy. Another beautiful save from the youngster there.
Good pressure to win the
and
ball
it's absolutely incredible stuff.
And that puts them in position. And
off the post. Birmingham making it incredibly hard for me so far.
Well, so close to breaking the deadlock, but not to be. The woodwork came to the rescue, Derek.
A terrible, terrible pass there. This is the toughest game I've played so far. Tougher than Derby.
He's in with a chance.
Got to win that header, always wins that.
And we will have just one additional minute. The first
half. Last in the first half, I guess. Neil Etheridge signing for Birmingham. I don't know whether that's in real life or not. I'm not that smart in the Championship. Don't know much about the Championship, to be honest. I'm more of a Bundesliga, Premier League person, you know. So, and I do like. So yeah.
And a throw in forthcoming.
1-1 at half time. Save 1-on-1. Down well. This is an absolutely incredible goalkeeper. I think he's just knocked Westwood out of his first team spot.
It was well stopped. Well, positioning is everything for a goalkeeper.
And he does like
then.
Westwood as well. He's obviously had throwing lessons from Kieran in the training grounds.
Good idea, that particular move.
Tackled easily. Palmer into Brown. Chasing them on the counter-attack. Trying to keep up. Brown cuts inside. Looking for Windus. Oh, and Somerville couldn't turn. Oh, but it's played over the top. But he's offside. Thankfully, he's offside. I'm getting really worried here.
Izzy Brown. It's with Josh Windass. Is it going to be?
Oh, well, and Xerxes should have finished. At least hit it on target. Oh, I just brought Harris on, didn't I? We're going to lose, guys, now. Now Harris is on, we're going to lose. Actually, I might have to sub him off. He'd have been a waste of a sub, wouldn't he? Now I've got to keep him on. Westwood has gone back down to 71. He's so inconsistent. He's such an inconsistent keeper. Bill.
Yeah, the fixtures come in thick and fast. Should be a good game, that. Though hopefully that's
over
not
into
the
commentator's
curse.
Xerxes loses out, though, to the defender. Should have done better there.
Can they hit on the break?
And a terrible ball over the top from Birmingham.
It is to be a throw-in.
It's going to go out for a throw-in. We need to get another goal here. At Ivy Lane. Well, I think that's what this place is called. It's not the real Birmingham.
Izzy Brown.
City ground. He just said city ground. Yeah, not the normal Birmingham city ground. Ooh. But Xerxes, that's actually a perfect timing. I don't know whether you can hear the commentators or not. Xerxes should have landed that, mate.
Did a brilliant job then.
I think we've got double gangers in this team, you know. I think Brown and Xerxes at the same face. We'll have to check after this game. That yeah, I think we've got double gangers, which is great.
Keeping us right up to date. Tension building still level. Must be.
Oh, straight into the beautiful hands of Lop. God, why did I call his hands beautiful? The things they've done is beautiful. I'll give him that. The things that his hands have done this game is absolutely stunning. But the actual look of them isn't beautiful with those default gloves. I'll change his gloves, I'll change his boots, I'll untuck his shirt.
And he's in.
Xerxes, finish!
But
oh, well, if you shot one touch earlier,
like
Neil Etheridge would have had no chance. The defender closing in on him well. I think this is going to be a 1-1 draw as
Ivan
things stand,
Sanchez.
But Birmingham on the attack. Outmuscled again. We had a brilliant team talk at half time, yeah. I got them all on FaceTime, you know, because I'm not there, unfortunately. Got them all on FaceTime. Told them they was playing well, but we need to be harsher on Birmingham. And that's what they've done this second half. But there's still time for Birmingham to get a second. But there isn't time for us to counter. Well, the two teams certainly went. A 1-1 draw against Birmingham, I'll take that, but Lupp is an incredible goalkeeper, absolutely top notch this boy is. He is going to be, those saves he did kept us in that game, and it's absolutely incredible what he's done so far. So he deserves to be edited. I believe I have edit plays on. I do. They've removed the they've unfortunately removed the catalog, which is a shame. There was some great stuff in there which we wouldn't be able to use. There we go, Lep. We need to edit you, don't we? So, what do you guys... How old is he then? So, he's from Estonia, born in 2003. 11th of June is his birthday. He's called Juku Lep. That's good to know, Juku. He is 6'1". He's 174 pounds. Right. So, we're obviously going to untuck his shirt. I'm gonna put him on tight fit because I mean I like tight fit things. Oh, we can wear pants. No, I think that's looking a little bit dodgy. That's funny. It's looking a little bit dodgy. We'll put what's the team fit? Oh, the team fit's normal. We'll put him on tight fit, you know, flexing those things. Boots. I'm gonna see if my boots are in this game, the boots that I wear. Because I actually have the, if they are, I would have the bang on boots. I went into the right place. I've got these on AstroTurf, but looks like my actual boots aren't in the game anymore. That is so sad. So sad. What do they look like? Well, I want to get good looking boots for this guy. Yeah, Adidas Predators. Why not? And gloves. Oh, they look nice. I'll see if my gloves... Oh, wow, that actually looks horrid. We might get in the Predators. But the rest are just EA Sport ones. You know what, we're giving the Phantom Elite. I'll give him the Vapor Grip. Why not? Lep is looking sharp. And... that is where we will wrap up the video. Thank you everybody for watching in episode 4 of our Sheffield Wednesday career. Thanks a lot for tuning in, and make sure to hit that subscribe button, like the video, check the description down below where XReapersNYT will be linked. And I have also just remembered, let me turn on my light. I have also remembered that my scout has given me a detailed description. So the replacement for Klein is this would be next year. 67 rated, and he is called. I'll put Amma, and I'll see if he comes up. So we'll try and find Amma. Okay, there's lots of Ammas, which is great. It looks like Amari. Looks like it could be this guy. Yep, probably is. I think it's this guy. So I'll shortlist this guy in the transfer hub. If it isn't, I'm sorry. So I probably got that wrong. But yeah, he's also given me a load of other players like Jordan Ayew. Milner maybe next year. A guy called Coman on loan. So yeah, he's been doing lots of work for me. So thank you for that. So yeah, that will wrap up the video. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Normal weeks, we should be getting an upload on Saturday and Sunday. But we might only, some weeks we might only get one. But there'll hopefully be one on a Friday. And definitely be one over the weekend. But obviously it's changing now. As we have, wow, I'm lost for words already. As we have the holidays, so there should be more there. Thanks everybody for watching, and I'll catch you soon. Goodbye.